Hi, welcome to a video tutorial from Equazer. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. In this video, we are going to use this Casio FX991 ES Plus, second edition scientific calculator, to evaluate definite integral and evaluate derivatives. Let's get started with this. To let you know that this calculator can't give you an equation answer. So the answer that we are getting will be only a number. And let's see if we have a definite integral, square root of sine x dx, pi over 2 to pi. We press integral, and we press the square root function, sine, and then we enter x. For x, we press alpha, and this x with the red, and then close it. This is done. Now with arrow come to the right. When you come to the right, you are out of the square root, and then it moves here to this point where we enter pi over 2. For pi, we're using this button with shift. Shift pi over 2, and then come to the right, and one more time, it moves from here to there, and then pi, because the upper bound is pi. Everything is completed. Now press equal. You must set your angle properly, otherwise the answer that you are getting will be incorrect. And here is the answer, and it took this much time to do the calculation. This is our function, square root of sine x, and here is the function which we have evaluated from pi over 2 at this point up to pi. And here is the answer, 1.198, which we got 1.198. This plot has been provided from desmos.com. I will provide you the link under the video in the description. And the unit here was radian. If the unit is not radian, you can press shift setup and go to radian number 4. So this way you can change the unit and do the calculation. If you change the unit to degree and press equal sign, you will see that the answer will be different and it will be incorrect. 0.31, so that's incorrect answer, and it was very quick. Now let's see how we can do this one. Press all clear, press integration, and then x squared, press alpha, and then x, and then squared. This is very simple. Come to the right, it goes to the lower bound, 1, and come to the right again, it goes to the upper bound, 2. Now for this, it's unitless, and the answer is 7 over 3, or 2.333. Here is our function, and this is our integration, and the area under the curve shows like this. So from 1 to 2, and as you can see, the answer is 2.333. And now let's see how we can evaluate the derivative at a point. For example, this function here that you see, 2x squared minus 3x plus 2, this is the velocity of an object, and if you take the derivative, it will be the position. So usually the question would be, find the position or evaluate the derivative at 2. So what it means is, evaluate the derivative at 2, or find the position of an object at 2 seconds and at 3, and for example at 4. So let's see how we can do it. All clear. For derivative, we are pressing shift and this button, shift, and you will see derivative here. And 2x squared minus 3, 2, shift x squared minus 3 plus minus 3 shift x plus 2. And because this is d of the function over x, come to the right and let's do first this one, evaluated with 2. So what it does is, it takes the derivative and then plugs in the 2 into the result of the derivative. And here is the answer is 5. go to the left with the arrow and again back, edit it with 3, and it is 9. And let's go with a 4, go to the left twice, delete 4, and this way you can evaluate it multiple times. And if you're doing derivative of cosine or something, make sure to set the unit to radian. To access all my other videos related for this calculator, please check the link below the video in the description. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this Casio FX-911ES Plus second edition scientific calculator. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates on my upcoming videos. Or press all clear, recall X, and we got the exact value. If you want the 1500, and then the same way 2302 equal 3 equal 0 equal, and then 8198 equal 1 equal 9 equal. Once you're done, you can, if you cannot read, minus alpha X plus 1